Hi, welcome to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about color palettes in Squarespace. I'm going to be sharing with you some little insider tips about how Squarespace works with your color palette. So once you've loaded your color palette into Squarespace, how does it come up with all the crazy combinations that it does? It can seem a little confusing, but once you understand how it works, it'll be a lot less confusing and you'll be able to move forward with confidence when creating your website. Before I dive in on that, if we haven't met, I'm Meg. I'm a Squarespace web designer for women service providers and the founder of Floating Lotus Design. So maybe you've worked with a brand designer, maybe you've come up with a great color palette of your own, and you finally have your brand colors ready and you want to load them into your website and start designing. Well, there's a few things you need to consider first so that you have the best outcome and it makes it a little bit simpler and easier for you once you're creating your website. So let's head over to my demo site and I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about. All right, so I'm here on a page and I've already gone ahead into site styles and opened up the colors window. And if you're not familiar with this, real quickly, this is where you can edit and adjust your palette and you'll see all the different themes that Squarespace will automatically come up with based on your color palette. And this is where you can make edits and changes to that. So the first thing I want to point out is this is loaded with a 5-color palette. So Squarespace does limit you to loading in only 5 colors in your color palette. You may be saying, but wait, I've got 7 or 9 or 10 or 12. And that's okay. But for your website, you're going to need to narrow it down to 5. And you're going to need it to go from lightest to darkest with your brightest in the middle. Now, that doesn't mean that you can't use any of those other colors in your website. And I'll show you later, there's ways that you can customize or in certain pieces of text, add in a different color, but you need to settle on your 5 base colors for your palette for your website. Now, I mentioned going from lightest to darkest. You'll see here, these 5 colors are broken up into 2 over here, 2 over here, and 1 big one in the middle. Why? Well, one, it's just a visual. Don't get too wrapped up in it. But if you want to understand it, it goes from lightest to the next light, to your bright, to your dark, and to your darkest. Usually this middle, this bright, is your pop, your accent color. Now, if I click on either one of these, you will go into where you could edit them. And it's a little bit easier to understand if you're thinking left to right, lightest to darkest, with your brightest, your pop, your accent color in the middle. Now, once you've loaded those in, and you come back here, you'll notice that Squarespace automatically comes up with themes based on those colors. It comes up with 10 themes. Now, to be honest, most people will kind of stick around 2 or 3 themes that they use regularly throughout their website. Very rarely do I see people make use of all 10. But one thing you want to keep in mind here is that each of these themes are what you apply to a section. So if I'm over here, I come out of site styles and I come over here. I look at this section here, and I want to edit the section. This is where I choose which color theme I'm going to use for each section. So just remembering that your color themes are applied section by section in your website, not page by page and not across the entire website. You do it section by section. So in this example, this is the one that's highlighted. I'm using the light 1 theme for this particular section. So if I go back into my colors, what Squarespace does is it comes up with these variations. I mentioned that as you create sections, you get to choose whatever theme you want. The themes, however, are global. And what I mean by that is that if you make changes or you edit any of the presets, shall we say, to these color themes, it's going to apply universally. So if you used, in this example, we have light 1. If I've used light 1 for a section somewhere else on my website, and I make a change to it to, say, change the background to orange, every other section on my website that is already using light 1 will also have its background change to this orange. So any changes you make to a theme will apply to that theme universally across your site. So I always caution people to not customize their themes too much until you understand how this works and you know what and where you're making these changes to. So let's just go over showing you the changes that you can make just by switching the theme. So let's go back here and choose a different color theme. So if I go with lightest one, see in this one, just the background is changing. Lightest two, really not much of a difference here. We've already seen light one, but let's go to bright one. Whoa, we get a different pop of color here, and so forth and so on. So you can see how certain elements, so like, you know, this example here, the main difference is the font is white, and this turns into that orange. You can go into this darkest point. So you can design a section and then play around with different themes and seeing how different elements like buttons, fonts, backgrounds, things like that. You know, if you have elements that might have a background color to them, the background color might change. So you can play around with that and see what you get by changing just the theme without doing anything more than that. Now you might want to come up with a custom theme. Maybe there's a specific color combination that you like, that you have tested it for the appropriate contrast levels, but you don't see that anywhere in any of these themes. What I would recommend, especially if you're not using all 10 themes, is pick one theme, let's say this darkest one, and go in and make the edits to just that theme and make that your one specialized custom theme that you might be using throughout your site. This is something I don't encourage folks who are real novices. This is something I would recommend you do once you're a little bit more comfortable, have been working within Squarespace a while, and you kind of understand how things affect each other. But if you get to that point that you want a real customized theme that you can apply somewhere, choose one that you're never going to use, and then you can go in and make those tweaks. And the reason I say that is because as we scroll through here, these are all of the potential elements that you could have in a section on your website. Every type of card, every type of block, every type of text, blogs, videos, product pages, if you have e-commerce. You know, it goes beyond just your simple section background text and buttons. The cards on your image blocks, the different types of image blocks, the style. So it gets very, very detailed. Your forms, your newsletter block. You get my point. I'm scrolling and scrolling. There are a lot of elements. So you really want to be sure you understand what you're changing, where you're changing it, and being mindful of that. And again, as I mentioned before, you don't really want to be like, oh, this section on this page, I really just want this button to be, you know, white with black font on it, and then go into that light one theme and change that, because then you need to change it across your entire site if you use this theme anywhere else. So you really have to be mindful before you get into kind of this slightly more advanced idea of tweaking and editing your themes and your color. You know, if you're doing this yourself, if you're working with a designer who's very familiar with Squarespace and does this, they can certainly do this for you and do it quickly and easily. But where you can, stick with the themes that Squarespace comes up with for you. Again, don't feel that you need to or should use all 10. Come up with what's consistent for you, for your brand or your website, and go with that. I recommend, you know, and what I see often is most people are sticking with around, you know, 2 to 3, sometimes 4 or 5. You can always add in an extra pop somewhere, but this just gives you an idea of what comes by default and that works well together, you know, because the algorithm, the coding behind the scenes is coming up with good combinations here that you can use. But, you know, you maybe aren't feeling a dark background anywhere and you don't have to use that. Now, aside from creating a custom theme or tweaking one of these particular themes to get exactly how you like, what can you do within a section itself that you can make tweaks to without impacting that theme across your website? Well, let's take a look. So if I come back here, and let's say you said, well, I have this color that I really wanted to use, but it's not in my 5. How can I apply it? So I'm going to highlight this text here. So you do have the ability to go in here, if you see this little colored dot, and you can change just in this section. It won't affect anything else on your site, no matter what theme you've used, just this text in section, and I can choose a different color from the palette that you've already loaded in, or you can go and put in a custom color. This goes back to my point, is if you have more than 5 colors in your color palette and there's an accent that you want to use sometime, where can I do that? Well, this is where you can do that. If you have that hex code for that color, you can just type it in here. I don't have one right now, so let's just pick a really crazy color and see what we come up with. So let's try this color palette over here. Let's maybe go with like this purple. Let's see what it comes up with. You can see I can change the color of just that text to that crazy wild accent color, but I'm not impacting any text with this color theme set anywhere else on my site. So you can adjust that individually. Also, say you want to do some underlining or text. You have this ability wherever you see this color button to come up to choose something from your palette or go custom. Don't be tempted to edit your site-wide palette. Leave it. But you can go in custom and you can add in, I'm going a little nutty with the color combinations here. So you have places where you can adjust the color independently without impacting other things. I'm going to undo that because that's just ugly. And you have things like the background. You can turn the background on for that text block. Well, the default background for the text block is, in this particular theme, is white. But I can change that white by hitting this little style background. And again, background color. Right now it's white. What if we made it orange? What if we made it green? You can choose, again, from your color palette. You can adjust the transparency. So if I did this, oh, what if I made that charcoal? So you have the ability to play with individual elements, not every element, but where you see that ability to change color, this is your opportunity to, oof, that is awful. This is your ability to go in and add those extra colors you couldn't use otherwise, or, you know, come up with a custom color just for that one element. So you do have some flexibility without impacting everything on your site in that theme. So that would be my recommendation for you if you are just going to have a few places throughout your website, certain sections that you want to throw in a pop of color or change the style of something without going through and editing a complete color theme, which you can get down a rabbit hole. You can forget what you changed, and then it can be really, really confusing. You know, you can even change the border color of your divider. So here we have our divider. It currently has no outline, but if I wanted to add an outline, let's make it really thin, I could also change the color of that. Again, these are all individual items. It's not impacting you site-wide, so you do have a lot more flexibility than you might realize, so play with those items first, get the hang of it, and don't be tempted to go in and adjust these themes until you really understand what you're doing and what they're going to change and impact. The last thing I will note here, if you haven't seen my other video on color contrast, there's a very important accessibility point that you do want to make sure that the contrast that you use with your colors, so when you're laying colors like we have here, this vibrant purple on a light background, with these color palettes that you choose, and when you're especially looking at text on a background, you want to make sure that the color contrast, the ratio of the contrast between those two colors, is at least 4.5 or above. And I go over exactly how to check that and why that's important, and I'll link that video up above. But it's really important when you compile your color palette that you are creating appropriate levels of color contrast so that your content can be read and viewed well by everyone. So hopefully that removes a little bit of the mystery or confusion around how to properly load your color palettes in Squarespace and how it treats them with its different color themes that it creates, and how you can most effectively make appropriate edits and do a little extra customization without having to delve into creating a whole new theme or editing themes and getting lost and not remembering what you fixed and what you didn't. So now that you understand a little better, hopefully you'll feel a little bit more confident about working with colors in your Squarespace website.